I'm not gonna sign your record. We're getting ready for fucking play. Come on now. Be reasonable. Jesus Christ. We got work to do. But before we get ready to do our work, I need to let you know the reason we subjected you and all of the crowds that we play for while we're touring to Herb Alpert, who's one of the genius horn players of our time. And he's more punk rock than any of you will ever be. In Circle Jerk's history, we had the opportunity to sign with Herb Alpert's record label called A&M Records, which would be Peter Frampton, The Police, all sorts of fun bands. Squeeze, Procol Harum, Blodwyn Pig. Did you ever play the Blodwyn Pig song with the Dickies? The Dickies covered Blodwyn Pig. See, now here's another part of our Southern California historical situation, and that is our friends the Dickies play a song by this band that I just mentioned, Blodwyn Pig. Okay, anyways, our guy at A&M Records comes and sees us at a place called the Starwood and fucking wigs out like, I gotta sign these guys. They're freaks. This is a great band. I gotta sign them. I'll get them signed to A&M Records. He goes to A&M Records. They say, what the fuck are you thinking? No. The Circle Jerks can never sell a million, zillion, billion records. No, get out of here. Get out of here. So he comes up with another bright idea. There's a record label called IRS, which is attached to A&M. And so he says, I'll go to IRS, which is the Go-Go's and the Cramps. R.E.M. from this part of the world. Anyways, they at IRS tell our guy the same thing that A&M Records told him, and that was, don't let the door hit you in the ass on the way out. So now we're reduced to just about nothing. Then he comes up with the brilliant idea. There's another record label attached to IRS, which is their farm system. And so we were like, okay, we'll go there. So that way we could be label mates with the Anti-Nowhere League in the fall and Chelsea and our friends from San Francisco, the Dead Kennedys. So we are out promoting actually our first three records, because while we were out promoting our first two records, it was time for the 40th anniversary of our third record, Golden Shower of Hits. Look, I'm almost done with my spiel, so just be patient, okay? Because we're not going anywhere. It's a Wednesday night. We will be playing the majority of the songs off of our first two albums and a bunch of songs off of our third record. We will, when all is said and done by the end of the night and you're all just excited and happy and feeling great, we will have played 31 songs for you. This is Xander. Do not repeat. Do not ask Xander to give you vaping instructions. Because he'll do it. He'll just stand there right. He'll just stand there while we're playing a song and show you how to vape. That's Greg. You know Xander, Kevin from Repo Man. That's Greg. You know Greg. Bad Religion, Red Cross, the Tourists. Don't be in such a goddamn motherfucking hurry. Like I said, we are not going anywhere until we play 31 songs. I'm Keith. This is the newest member of our band. We would not be doing this if Joey was not playing with us. The Joey C. Show some respect and make some noise. We're the Circle Jerks.
We can't. We never go.
You get along with your parents? I always get along with my mom, which means I'm a mama's boy, which is totally fine by me because my mom is fucking highly intelligent. Okay, now on the other hand, my dad, I did not get along with my dad. Not until the circle jerks. Is it our fourth album? When my dad actually sat me down and said, "It sounds like you don't have anything else to say. You've already said everything you were going to say."
No, you know, when I was holding your drink, I was holding
which
your drink.
Which can be better. But anyways,
I don't trust anyone near.
I wrote a song for my dad called Letter Bomb.
Thank you.
You know how we played Nirvana before we played our set? Part of that reason is because we're just fun-loving guys who want to know where the party is, want to hang out with all of the happy kids, want to do all of the fun things that all the other fun people do. Well, now we get to set that aside and get into some really ugly, shitty, nasty. That's how I explain or describe this next batch of songs. Under the Gun.
Thank you.
that we were gonna create a set list like we've created, where we're playing blocks of songs, and that means we play a block, and then we get a little bit of a break. You know, the 60-year-old senior citizen man gets to tell a story or... dry off, or... drink a little drinky poo. But what it also does, it allows Xander. Xander, did you get your vape pen? Hurry up now, get your vape pen. From here, like standing and watching your horizontal, your fucking whatever, it looks like you were giving Frosty the Snowman a blowjob. What it also does is it allows Joey to collect his thoughts, because he gets all worked up. He wants to play these songs faster, and we can't fucking keep up. Greg gets to come back here and tune his guitar so he can play all of these songs properly, just for you. This is our fourth block of songs, and it starts with a song called Moral Majority. Punk rock history for you.
Fuck yeah!
Because that's where we're from. That's what we grew up with. And we were fortunate to have seen a couple of bands with some of our friends. Yeah, be nice. Be nice. Okay. Yes. Because worse things happen. So, we have a couple of buddies, a couple of friends in a couple of bands. One being Tito LaRiva, who played in a band called The Plugs. Who at one time was one of the original members in a band called The Flesh Eaters with Chris Dean, who also worked at Slash Records and was responsible for X, Fear, Dream Syndicate, The Blasters, The Gun Club. They were in this band, they wrote this song, they recorded it, but never released it. It's sitting on in a tape on a shelf somewhere in Austin, Texas, or wherever it is. But I went to them, Greg saw The Plugs play the song twice, and I saw The Flesh Eaters play the song twice, and I went to those guys and I said, look, what, yeah, hold on. Don't put your fucking underwear get punched up your fucking cheeks, okay? Settle down. Dude, mellow out, okay? Just fucking mellow out. Yeah. We'll get to the song when I'm through with my spiel. They said, Keith, we love Black Flag, we love the Circle Jerks. You go ahead and play it. I and I.
Yeah.
Okay, we'd like to take this opportunity to thank each and every one of you for being here tonight. But of course we can't do that because we'd be here until the end of the week. Thank you. We would also like to thank these guys up front that are keeping people from falling over and damaging themselves. We would also like to thank all of the people that work here at this venue and the venue itself for allowing us to play here. Hey, Brett, we played here, not this venue, but we played Charleston, what, 35 years ago? Yeah, 35 years ago. Hey, thanks for coming out. We would also like to thank our friends, because we know all of the guys in the bands that are playing with us, because we become friends with them. We would like to thank our friends, John Brannon, and Ron, and Harold, and Mr. Meat, from Detroit, Michigan. Negative Approach. Okay, Negative Approach from Detroit. We would also like to thank Jack Grisham, Ron Emery, and their accompanying rhythm section from the Orange County, Long Beach, Huntington Beach. Just slightly north of the black hole in Anaheim. TSOL. Okay. Five more songs. Thank you. We'll be right back. Thank you.